This is a pre-built version of the application. So if we go ahead and run this script, which will create and populate an SQLite database containing the same data as in the original application. And now if we run the application, we went from generation 0 to generation 8. So the goal is that given this data that is coming from the database, we need to find a schedule with no conflicts using genetic algorithms. And a conflict can be one of three things. It can be an instructor assigned to teach more than one course at the same time. It can also be a room occupied by more than one course at the same time. And it can also be a course scheduled to be taught in a room with a seating capacity that is smaller than the maximum number of students for the course. So we went from this generation where the fittest schedule had three conflicts, and this is a table representation of that schedule. We went to generation 8 where the fittest schedule, this one, had zero conflicts. And let's try to find the conflicts for this one. So this is one of the conflicts. The room maximum capacity is smaller than the maximum number of students for the course. And this is another one. And this is the third one. We have room 3 having two classes scheduled to be taught at the same time on Tuesday, Thursday from 9 to 10:30. And each population of schedules is sorted by fitness. Now the simple test data used here had three departments, a math, a double E, and a physics department. The math one had two courses offered, and the double E 3, and the physics 2. And we have 7 courses in the system, and those are the maximum number of students for each one of the courses. And those are the qualified instructors for each course. And we have 3 rooms, and those are the seating capacity for each room. And 4 instructors, and 4 meeting times. Monday, Wednesday, Friday from 9 to 10, and from 10 to 11, and Tuesday, Thursday from 9 to 10:30. And from 10:30, I will start by creating a new folder. And we will copy this file and paste it here. And let's rename it. So it's class scheduling plus DB, and those two files create and populate the database, this one with a version of the original application and this one with an updated version. and we need to import the SQLite. And replace this hard-coded data with the data coming from the database. And let's go down here. One here so that the schedules start with the number one instead of zero, and the same thing for generation. Actually, here for courses starting from one instead of zero in a schedule, and here for schedule in the generation or population of schedules. And I would like to replace this with DB manager, and we're only using it here, so we just need to replace it here. And let's test run the application. So let's do this. Let's delete this. And we'll create a new database and run this again. And here we go. So we found this schedule with no conflicts in this generation. And this is updated database. So we added a statistics and data science department offering two courses, and we added one course to the math department. And those are the three courses here, and the maximum number of students for each, and the qualified instructors for each one of those courses. And we added a room to the rooms, and this is its maximum seating capacity, and we added one instructor. And we started from this generation where we had six conflicts, and we ended up in this generation with zero conflicts. So Mike Brown is teaching two classes on Tuesday and Thursday, and James Webb two classes on a different date. Actually two classes on Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and one on Tuesday, Thursday. And Steve Day only one class, and Jane Doe two classes on different dates, and same for Julia Blue. And room 4 has two classes on Tuesday, Thursday, and one class on Monday, Wednesday, Friday. And room 1 has only one class, and room 2 has two classes on Tuesday, Thursday, and two classes on Monday, Wednesday, Friday. and room 3 has two classes on different dates. And the room capacity for each one of the rooms is bigger than the max number of students for each one of the courses.